गाइस टुडे वी विल डिस्कस फाइंडिंग कैंडिडेट कीज ऑफ अ रिलेशन बाय क्लोजर. ओके सो इट इज अ क्वाइट इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट विच कम्स अंडर द नॉर्मलाइजेशन. इन द नॉर्मलाइजेशन वी हैव टू फाइंड द कैंडिडेट कीज, सो इट विल हेल्प यू लॉट इन दैट कॉन्सेप्ट. सो बी अटेंटिव देयर. फाइंडिंग द कैंडिडेट कीज ऑफ अ रिलेशन, देयर मे बी अ वन टू और मैनी कैंडिडेट कीज. वी हैव टू फाइंड ऑल दैट पॉसिबल कैंडिडेट कीज फ्रॉम द रिलेशन, बट द मेन थिंग इज दैट we have to use only the closure concept. We have done already the closure concept of functional dependencies and the attributes. Let's see what exactly the definition says here. The candidate keys, it is the minimal set of attributes whose attribute closure is set of all attributes of relation. That means if we say this is the set of attribute which is considered as the candidate key, then we have to prove that key. If we take the closure of that set of attribute, it will give us all the attributes of that relation. Then we are going to say that this is yes a candidate key of relation. Okay, so let's take an example. It will clear out everything. There is a relation that is called under which we have the five attribute, that is A, B, C, D, E. Okay, and these are the functional dependency from AB to C, then CD to E, then DE to B. This is the three functional dependency. So we have to find a candidate key. So how we have to do? There is some strategy which we have to follow to finding the candidate key. Let's see what is that. First of all, you have to write this all functional dependency in this way. Okay, so write down all the your left hand side attributes like this. This is CEB. That means we can write in short method BCE. This is all the our left side attribute which exist in functional dependency. We have written that. What are the remaining attributes? The remaining attributes are A, D. Okay. After that, we have to use this AD with B, then AD with C, then AD with E. Because AD is the first minimal attributes by which we can find the candidate key. Okay guys, so after that AD, we have to use B, AD with C, then AD with E. Then we will see that if their attribute closure give us all the attributes of the relation. Let's see how. We have to find, let's see first we attach that AD with B. Okay, and we have to find the its attribute closure. So we will write like this way. This is the closure sign. Then what it will give us? It will give us A, B, and D. At least we know by the axiom, it will give us A, B, and D. We do not need to find more functional dependency. We will can use the all the axiom and find each and everything. Let's go from ADB. ADB gives us A, B, D. Okay. After that, we will see that the combination which exists here, and we will put their corresponding value. So what are the corresponding there? AB, from AB to we can find the C. So we can write that from AB we can find the C plus D. Okay, and from other combination, let's see how we can, remaining one is the E. So how we can find the E? E can be find with the value of CD. Is there CD? Yes, CD exists here. So we will write A, B, C, D, E. I'm not using comma right now. You can use it or not, does not matter, because all the values should be there. So has all the value has come? Yes, A, B, C, D, E, A, B, C, D, E. All the attributes are here by using this closure, this attribute closure. So we will say that ADB is that closure or is that candidate key by which we can find all the attributes. Okay, so we will say candidate key is here A, D, B. Okay, it's closure, or you wanna use, don't use. Okay, C. Okay, candidate key is A, D, B. Let's find other combination exist here. A, now we combine the AD with C. AD with C, and we have to find the its closure, attribute closure. Let's see what will be the output. From ADC we can find the A, C, D. Okay guys, A, C, D. Okay, and now we will match the other combination. There is a one combination that CD, from CD to we can find the E. So we will add here A, C, D, E. Okay, now what is the remaining one? That is the B. How we can find it? With the combination of DE. Is there DE? Yes, there is a DE. Then we can write that from the combination of, please remove these commas. Okay, A, from DE we will find the B. So we can write that A, B, C, D, E. Okay, all the attributes are here with the closure of ADC. Then we can say that ADC is also our candidate key. A, D, C. Okay guys, now move to another combination, that is AD with E. Let's see what will be the output. We will find the attribute closure of A, D, E. Okay, let's see what will be the output. A, D, E will be at least here. And after that, let's see the combination. Is there any combination? From D, E, I can find the value of B. Okay, so I will write A, B, D, E here. Okay, now the what is the remaining one? C. C can be found with the value of AB. So is there AB? Yes, there is AB. So we can use AB to find the value of C. All the attributes are here. Okay guys, so we will say that ki ADE is also a candidate key of this relation. So candidate key is ADE. So we have the three candidate keys, that is ADB, ADC and ADE. Okay guys, so this is how we can find the candidate key of a relation by finding the closure of minimal set of attributes. Okay, so just remember that you just arrange all the functional dependency in this order and take all the attributes, left side attribute in the left side, and then remaining attributes from the all attributes will be at the right side, or will be left side. Okay, sorry, left side. This is at the right side. Then we will combine this right side left side attribute with the left side, right side attribute. Then AD to B, AD to C, then AD to E. Okay guys, so you have to see this combination and find each and every closure. If we get all the attributes, then we will say that it is a candidate key. Otherwise, it's not a candidate key. Okay guys, but in the next video, we will take an example. If there's many functional dependency in which all the attributes exist in the right hand side, then what you will do, then we will see in the next example ki how we will solve that kind of question. So get ready with that question. Okay guys, so guys, if my videos are helping you, please share and like these videos, and please follow this channel. Okay guys, thank you and take care. Please don't forget to follow the playlist of the video. Okay guys, thanks.